Have you ever seen a coral reef? They're bright, they're beautiful, they're like underwater cities. Now imagine the same reef suddenly turns white, quiet, empty. That is coral bleaching, and it's one of the biggest warning signs from our oceans. What coral actually is? First off, coral is not a plant, and it's not a rock either, it's an animal. Tiny ones, actually, called polyps, all living together in big groups. They build reefs over time, kind of like underwater apartment buildings. But here's the secret. Coral can't do it alone. Inside their cells live tiny algae called Zooxanthellae, mostly from the genus Symbiodonium. Yeah, it's a weird word. Zooxanthellae give coral its rich, vibrant color. Even better, they feed it. They use sunlight to make food through photosynthesis, like plants do. Zooxanthellae also contribute to the light-boosted calcification process in some coral species, which is crucial for the quick formation of reef structures. In exchange, the algae receive protection and vital nutrients. It's teamwork. It's a beautiful symbiotic relationship, powering the entire reef. So what causes bleaching? Here's where things go wrong. When ocean temperatures rise, even just a little, things get dangerous. Corals are sensitive to temperature changes. They thrive best in a range of 26 to 29 Celsius degrees. However, a rise of just 1 or 2 degrees can trigger bleaching. That's like your room going from comfy to oven in minutes. Heat stresses the algae. They start to produce harmful molecules called reactive oxygen species, or ROS. Think of it like the algae getting sick. And when they do, they poison the coral by accident. The coral responds by kicking them out. So the coral kicks them out. No more algae, no more color, no more food. That's coral bleaching. The coral turns pale or bright white. Corals rely on algae for up to 90% of their energy. So it starts to starve. Now you're probably wondering, is bleached coral dead? Not right away. Bleached coral is still alive. It can recover if the water cools down and the algae come back. For cooling, in a strange way, wind speed and even cyclones can sometimes protect corals. Why? Because they mix up the ocean and cool the water down. It's like giving the reef a break from the heat. But if the heat stays too long, the coral doesn't get the food it needs. It gets weaker, then it dies. And when coral dies, the reef breaks down. Fish leave. Ecosystems fall apart. It's like pulling bricks from a building until the whole thing crashes. So, to sum it up, coral and algae work together. If heat stress causes algae to produce toxins, coral kicks out the algae. And then coral turns white. And without food, it might die. That's coral bleaching. And now a little about what you can do to save the corals. Want to help? You don't need to be a scientist. Use less energy. Support clean energy. Eat sustainably. Support ocean charities. Speak up about climate change. Every little bit adds up. So what's next? In one of our next episodes, we'll look at underwater heat waves, how they form, and why they're striking faster and harder than ever. And spoiler, it's not just warm water. It's underwater firestorms. So hit that subscribe button and I'll see you there.